Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to give a demo on air process control trainer. In this trainer, we are going to control the air process. The medium is air and we are going to control the process of pressure through different types of controlling. In this, we are using PID controller basically with SCADA system to see the computerized performance of controlling the pressure, and this is the complete plant mimic. We will describe it in this video and then we see the practically perform how we control the air pressure or air pressure with the SCADA. So this is the basic plant mimic here to see the air process control trainer and to see the process of controlling air pressure in a pressure vessel. So we can use and completely understand the setup for this in this video. The order code for this system is pressure control trainer air. The order code is 5229. You can use this order code to find out the specification and details about the all parts and the experiment by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com, written over here also. And this is the complete mimic here in which all the details in one screen is provided. Same mimic can be also observed in the SCADA system as well. Now we are going to see different parts and to understand about the working of different parts, and then we see the practical in this trainer board. The main component of this system is this pressure vessel in which we will create the pressure by air using air as a medium. This is the complete system of cylindrical material with a diameter of 150 mm and length of 300 mm. And this is made of CRCC material, and there are one outlet for pressure transducer which is connected here. This can be measured range from 0 to 2.5 bar. And this is the pressure gauge here, dial with the 100 mm of dial, and this can be measured the pressure from 0 to 100 psi and 0 to 7 kilogram centimeter square in bar as well. This is the inlet line here for this, and this is the outlet line here for this pressure vessel, so that pressure can be easily get in the excessive output also. Now then we have a pneumatic control valve. This is a globe type valve with a drive arm here, and this is the supply to air to close type of valve, in which when we provide air via control any positioner, the valve will be controlled, and drive arm is connected with the spring here, and spring is connected with the rod to control the opening of valve. So valve is open and closed according to the air supply, and air supply is provided from this positioner. This is a positioner in which when we provide 4 to 20 milliampere in the electrical output, this will generate 3 to 15 psi pressure to control the diaphragm controlling and opening and closing of the pneumatic control valve. So this is the complete setup of a plant mimic. With this we have a AFR unit here, air filter and regulator unit, to regulate and filter the air supply to the valve. Because in the industrial area and the compressor generated air contains the moisture content, so we need to filter this all also. Then we have a PR unit, air pressure regulator unit. This unit need to be controlled because we need to control the pressure accordingly to check the safety measures, because and the pressure control is provided by this knob. When we turn this knob to clockwise, the pressure will increase, and then we turn this knob to anticlockwise, the pressure will decrease in the complete system. So this is the input line for the system as well. Then we have the pressure gauge here to see the input pressure for the electropneumatic control valve, globe type valve. So output pressure can be seen from the electrostatic positioner with this. Then we have on the panel, which is PID controller. This is a complete controller which is required to control the complete process of plant. In this, the PID controller works with the input of 4 to 20 milliampere and output of 4 to 20 milliampere as well. And this is the dual display controller, and in which process value and set point is given. This is the process value section and set value section, and inbuilt 24 volt DC power supply is for two wire pressure transmitter is connected. The complete setup with a bar graph of output will also given, and this complete system is on an LCD display for ease of access and ease of understanding. Very attractive design to see the controlling. Then we have transmitter output here, T1 and T2 terminal. This is the PID input terminal, T3 and T4. And these are the PID output terminal, T5 and T6. And this is the electro-pneumatic to current converter output. So when we transmitter's output will be connected to PID input, and PID output will be connected to electro-pneumatic converter current converter transmitter. Then we have mains on switch here. This is the PID controller on switch, and this is the 24 volt supply power on switch. So to see the inside the panel, you can open the both bolt opening here, and then you can easily open the panel from this handle. Here you will see the different connections inside. This is the SMPS to control the and convert the 230 volt AC supply to 24 volt DC supply in 3 amperes range. These are the terminal box in which all the connections are connected with the system and with the plant. And this is the MCB by which we will control the complete setup. So power on this supply is provided here. Then we have here USB to 232 converter by which we can communicate the complete study and SCADA with the PID controller to communicate the SCADA with. And this is the USB bridge, UART type of bridge, by which we can easily communicate all the data following with this. And this is the back side of PID controller here. All the connections and different working diagrams and the wiring diagrams are also provided in the user manual. Also, there are 4 page codes, 2 red and 2 black, to connect the outside terminal that I have already explained earlier. And this is a cable here with the UART bridge converter to communicate to connect with the PC. Now we are going to see how we experiment on the complete setup with this. So we'll follow the procedure as described in the user manual. The user manual contains all the information about all the different parts, including in this complete setup. And the complete setup is based and designed in a sturdy frame of MS powder coated design. At this, you can easily move the experiment and the complete setup of plant in the lab or any of the corridor in the college institutes and anywhere. And this with the wheels are with the lock mechanism. So when you are working with this, you can lock the wheels and start working so that the system cannot be movable and easily can be working on this. So now we are going to see the practical on this trainer. So we will follow the procedure. In this, the aim is to study the pressure loop in a control system with SCADA application, by which we will study the closed loop feedback pressure control system using pressure transmitter and SCADA application. So we have a objective for this. The four objectives: to understand the concept of feedback pressure control system, then we determine the system response and procedure for optimizing and setting of PID controller to suit process, and study the operation of pressure transmitter input and current to pneumatic converter and control valve. All the other objectives will be fulfilled by working with this complete trainer system. Now we will follow the procedure for this. We will first turn on the main, and then we turn on the PID controller here. And then we on the 24 volt power supply, all the three switches. Now we will connect the patch cords by using T1, T2, the output of transmitter, to connect with the PID input T3, T4. For this, the patch cords are provided. So we'll connect red, black, T1 with T3 and T2 with T4. So as I connected, the input is showing 00 here on the screen. Now for the output of PID controller, we will similarly connect T5 to T7 and T6 to T8. So the output to the pneumatic controller will be provided from the PID controller. Now for continuing the process, we need to connect the air supply from compressor line to the system. This is the input slot here for APR unit. We have to connect the air supply at this point. So we will connect the air supply using a 6mm PU fitting with the compressor line, and we'll on the air supply. In this system, we need to continuous air supply to set the complete setup and to perform all the experiments with this trainer board. After connecting the air line in the input slot, now we have to first adjust the PID controller setting. You can also do this while working and while keeping the pressure line on or the air pressure or air inlet on. But due to excessive air amount will be in the wasted form, I am trying to first setting to show you the setting, because it will take time to setting show you the setting in the video. After that, you can continuously supply make on and then do the settings. All the setting systems are given in the user manual also. You can see here, channel PID controller 1, channel 1 settings are given at this block, and channel 6 settings are given in this block. And rest of the other settings for PID and different types of values are also given in this user manual. You can use this all settings to do all setup in the PID controller. Now for entering the value in the PID controller, we will first select use these buttons, keys provided on the front panel of this PID controller. We will press select for 3 to 4 seconds, then we go inside the menu section. This is the channel 1 menu. To navigate the other channel, press up and down key like this. This is channel 6, 9, 11. Just we have to enter the value in the number 1 section, which is PID controller. To go inside the channel 1 menu for selecting PID, press select. Here the P value is given, so we have to enter the value of P, which is given 11.5 for this. So we'll increase the value by again pressing select. After the value in the green one start blinking, you can adjust the value by using up and down key. So I'm increasing the value. (clears throat) 11.5 we need to set this. Okay, after setting, press select. The value has been completed setting. Now for next menu, press down key. This is the value of I. At here we have to set the value 81 for this. So we'll start increasing the value. You can directly increase the one digit here by using this key. So I have shifted to one decimal point. So we have entered value 81 for this. Press select, the value has been entered. Now we go to next menu, which is D value. For D value, we have to set 8.9 here. So this is 8.9. Press select, the value has been entered. Now we go to the next menu. This is hysteresis. There is no need to change this. Default value 0 should be same. Balance should be 0. AR should be 2.5. Reverse action should be no. Select value low will be 0 and higher will be about 2.5. That is already set here. TC1 should be 1. PLC 1 need to minus 5. So we have to change PLC 1 to minus 5. Sorry, first press select, then we go to minus value. So we'll put this to minus 5. Press select, value has been entered. Then we go to PHC 1, this should be 105, press select. So we'll increase the value to 105 here. Okay, or press select to enter the value. Now P cut will be 0, alpha will be 40 and beta will be 100. So these are the value in channel 1 that have been set at completely. Now for going back to the main menu, press back button here. Now we go to channel 6. For going to channel 6, press menu here, press select to set the settings. In PVT we have to set 4 to 20 milliamps, which is already done here. For PVB we need to set 0, 0 is already entered, and for PVF 2.5 is the value, and for PVD we will set it to 2. So value of channel 1 and channel 6 has been completely entered. Now we can start our experiment by continuously providing a line, and then we follow the practical procedure as given in the user manual and see how we control the pressure using PID controller. Now we have turned on the air supply for the system. Now for air pressure we have to use the APR unit here, air pressure regulator unit, this, and we have to set the pressure using this knob up to 2.5 kg per second centimeter square for this experiment. So we will start using turning this knob to clockwise slowly, so you will see the pressure will increase inside the pressure gauge, and as we reach 2.5 kg we will press this knob, so this will pressure will be low. If you turn this knob to anticlockwise, the pressure will be decreased inside the pressure gauge. You can also see in the pneumatic control valve the position is at the shut position right now, because airline is completely in shut position, and also to provide the pressure to the air supply or the electropneumatic control positioner, which will be convert current signals to the air pressure pneumatic signal. So this line is directly going to the air pressure regulator or AFR unit. So we will set the AFR unit pressure about 2.1 kg because it is the maximum limit for pneumatic control valve here. Now we can also lock this. So we have provided the appropriate pressure to the pneumatic globe type control valve, and now we have to adjust the pressure inside the pressure vessel by using V4 valve, so that pressure inside the pressure vessel will be maintained about 2.5 kg per second per centimeter square. Now for adjusting the pressure inside the pressure vessel, we can see here on the dial gauge the pressure is approximately 2 bar 2 kg per centimeter square. Now we can use valve V4, which is now in the off position right now, so when we turn on the valve the pressure inside the pressure vessel will increase. So we will slightly turn on carefully the valve so that pressure will not exceed 2.5 kg per centimeter square. So we are increasing the pressure inside the pressure vessel about 2.5 kg per centimeter square, which is 2.5 bar right now, you can observe this. And pressure is increasing inside the pressure vessel as I continuously open the pressure vessel valve, the pressure will be increased inside. Now for excluding the pressure, you can also partially open the valve V5 so that pressure from the pressure vessel will be in continuously output flow, so that the safety measure will be taken and pressure inside the pressure valve continuously up and down. Here you can see pressure is slightly now going down. If I change the position of V4 as well, so inside pressure will be more decreased. So you have to adjust both the valves to perform the experiment properly. Continuous airflow is required for this, so valve adjustment need to be proper. Once you achieve the complete position, you will get the proper experiment doing with this. Now we have to provide any set point in the PID controller. So we'll start setting up the pressure inside pressure vessel to control. So first set point will be 1.5 for us. Use up and down key to change the set point here. So we have set the set point here and press select. Set point has been entered. Now you can observe the opening and closing of the pneumatic control valve. The pneumatic control valve is now in completely shut position. Output or input to the pneumatic control valve can be seen on the pressure gauge over here. This pressure gauge is giving the output of the input to the pneumatic control valve, and you can also observe the set point. In the PID controller is now achieving, it is process value about 1.54 here, and we have set the point 1.50 in the pressure. Also you can observe at the pressure gauge, the set point is also achieving in the actual value form, and this is the bar graph beneath the set value, the green value. So this bar graph is giving the opening and closing output percentage to the pneumatic control valve. So the percentage value can be giving here accordingly. As the pressure decrease, the pressure will be again, and pneumatic valve opening and closing will be in continuous form to set up the pressure as per the set point. So we have achieved our set point in the quick form. So this is how we control the pressure control loop using PID controller. Now if I change the set point for the PID controller value, the process will be again startup and continuous process will be happen to achieve the set point again. So as I change the set point here from 1.5 to 2.0, you can set any of the set point from 0 to 2.5 for this and press select. Here you can see opening is completely done, and valve opening and closing can easily achieve on the pneumatic controller. Pneumatic control valve here you can observe, and the pressure inside the pressure vessel is also increasing on the pressure gauge. So we have now achieving our new set point, which is 2.0 inside the pressure vessel, and feedback control is happening using pressure transducer, giving the feedback from the pressure vessel, and output from the PID controller is provided to the positioner here for controlling the air pressure and control valve of the airline. So again we have achieved our set point according to this. So that's how we control the pressure control using PID controller in a closed loop feedback system. Now you can also perform auto tuning with this controller for the system. So pressure and other PID value will be auto tuned according to pressure supply and the working components. For this you have to press select one time, then this is the manual mode which is in off condition right now, and when you press up and down, AT is the auto tune function here. So this is in off mode. So as I turn on this by selecting and turning on and again press select, the system will be auto tuned. This will be taking some time, 1 or 2, 3 cycles will be automatically done, and you will get your on set point according to your on PID values according to your auto tuning of the system. It will again do 1 or 2 cycle and then automatically goes to the main screen for set value and process value, and you will get your auto tuning output and PID values according to your pressure system and a pressure plant. Also, you can observe the valve position continuously opening and closing. So automatic tuning with the system and plant is going on through the PID controller. Here you can see the auto tuning has been completed and your set point is achieved. For this, after auto tuning the system, you can observe the PID values which have been changed. You can note down all the PID values and other values that we have entered before. So these values must be changed according to your system and according to your pressure line. Now after auto tuning, you can observe and see the PID values inside the parameters. We press select again for 3 to 4 seconds and go to PID menu. Here you can see that we have entered the PID value for P was 11.5, and after auto tuning we are getting 13.7. So this is the system recognition according to the plant and the air supply. This will change to person to person and process to process. After auto tuning we have get P value which is 13.5 for this system. I value is 7, that we have entered 81 for this. D value 1.3, that we have entered 8.9. So this depends on the factory system and another systems. If you work with your own system and out at your place, the values can maybe more differ from this. So it depends on supply, air supply and another components. Hysteresis is accordingly 0.1. Balance value 0, AR is air pressure regulation is 2.27 for this. Set value high is 2.5. PLC 1 will be minus 5 and this will be same. So PID values are more often what will be the changes while auto tuning. So that's how we perform the air process control system trainer. Now we will see the SCADA controlling of this to communicate the PID controller with the SCADA system inside. Now for communicating with the SCADA, you just need to connect the cable inside the panel that we have shown earlier. So this USB cable need to be connected to the USB slot of the PC. And as you connect the USB cable to the USB slot, then you have to open the CD folder that will be provided with the kit. So you have to open 5229. In this, the SCADA software is provided. The SCADA software folder need to be open, in which you will find the LF SCADA installer and USB driver. So first you have to install the USB driver. You can use the Windows 7 or 8 Fuji PID controller driver. So if you are working with OS Windows 7, you can use this and install this driver, or if you are working with Windows 10, you can use this driver as well. So this is the USB driver that we have already installed here. So now we will open the device manager. In the device manager, after installing the USB driver folder, you will get the COM port after connecting the USB cable to the laptop or your PC. As I remove the cable again, you will find that there is no USB showing, and again I am connecting the USB here, so you will get the COM port, Silicon Labs CP210 USB to UART bridge controller at the device manager. So COM port 2 we need to be mentioned in the software, SCADA software as well. So we will minimize this and go to SCADA. After installing the SCADA installer, you need to install the SCADA software. Driver installation also required. After installing the SCADA software, the file can be run and accessible for this. So if you own the air pressure SCADA file, you will find this complete setup. You just need to double click on the AP SCADA opening this and you will go to SCADA screen directly. If it asks you to no hard key found, run as demo, press yes. We need to run the software as in demo. Here, we have already selected the COM port. That's why you are finding the value in the SCADA pressure right now. So for selecting the COM port, if you do not have the COM port selection, like that I have changed the COM port 2 to 4 and press setting, our SCADA value will be missed. Here the value will not be entered right now and the value are false. So again we have to set the settings and press the COM port 2 to 2 and press save. Now if we press the PID controller, just click on the PID controller, you will get the PID controller window in which you are getting the process value, which is 2.6 kilogram per centimeter square right now, and the set value is 2.0 that we have set here. Output is 105%. Completely close the valve right now, and when you press the tune button you will get the actual graph of process value and set point with the time and output as well. Now if I change and release the pressure inside the pressure vessel, you will get changes in the graph line as well. If I slightly release the pressure from the pressure vessel, you can see the graph is going slightly down. Process value is also changing, approximately 1.942. So system again starts working to stabilize the system. Here you can see the wall is again turning on and off. The graph line can be observed. And sometime the set value and process value will be stabilized and both the lines of process value and set point will be coincide. Similar graph we will find in any of the feedback control system. When error is eliminated, we will get our set point value accordingly by feedback control system. Also you can observe the bar graph for output of closing and opening of the system. So this is the basic process value set point real time graph. If we close this, you can also observe the trend, actual trend with the process value here, and this is the process value with the time, and this is set point with the time, which is continuously same. And this is process value set point and time graph. This is now almost equalizing. And this is process value set point or output versus graph. And deviation is 0.3% for this system. Output is 83% here. So this is from an extremely outer range. So this is graphical representation of all the readings. Now you can generate the report or data logging every minute basis. You can get the reading of 11.1 minute here, 11.0 minute, 10:59, all the minutes reading, PID 1 value which is 2.0, process value, set point, PID output and experiment name. All the reports can be generated. You can generate Excel report here, graphical report like this. This is the graphical report for the complete system. And tabular report can also be printed directly. This table can be printed to any of the printer connected to a system. So this is how we see the air process control using SCADA controlling. And after working with the experiment, if your experiment has been completed, just press exit to exit the complete system. So that was the complete demonstration of feedback control system for pressure. The pressure has been controlled with the pneumatic control and PID controlling here, and we have used the feedback system for this complete setup. The plant mimic and complete description are also provided in this video. Hope you will get the better understanding about the system, and you can do all the experiments with this complete as described in this video. You can also refer the user manual for all the different details about the PID controlling and different theoretical knowledge about the system of working with the PID controller and how the other components are working and how we will achieve the system with this. So while working with this kit, if you find any difficulties, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of support. Thank you.